Economic inequality is the difference between the haves and the have-nots in any society. I'm Tim Kohler. I'm an archaeologist at Washington State University. Archaeologists have always been interested in inequality. In the societies that we study, we look at differences in house sizes to determine who is wealthy and who is not. I conducted this research with a group of researchers from all over the world. We have measured house societies in dozens of ancient societies representing hundreds of archaeological sites and thousands of households. Human societies have always had some degree of inequality, even in hunter and gatherer societies, but these inequalities accelerate with the advent of agriculture and then with the rise of the state. Economic inequality has a number of potentially pernicious effects. If it gets too high, it can have poor effects on health outcomes. It can cause a lack of social mobility within a society. It can perhaps even make a society less stable. This research is important because we are poised at high levels of wealth inequality now in many Western countries, including especially in the United States. One of the things we found was that when people are born into a society, they tend to think that the conditions in that society have always existed and are in some sense natural. What we understand by looking at archaeology is that there are many ways to organize societies. Our present manner of organization is only one of those. There are other possibilities out there in the world.